Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to the MCAT preparatory workshop. Yes, MCAT, as you all are aware, is going to give you the benefit of scholarship equivalent to the score that you're going to earn at the assessment. So be prepared for this assessment, and MESC is supporting you along with the partner training providers. So today we have a workshop on 3D animation, and here skill full of experience, illusion, and life learnings to prepare you for 3D animation. And the speaker today is very renowned. We have met him earlier as well, Mr. Parminder Singh Rubalji. A very, 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 very humble, polite, and a very generous professional with 18 years of industry experience in design and animation. He has been simultaneously active in both production and education since the onset of his career. During his career, apart from successfully handling countless animation and design projects for clients around the globe, he has mentored and trained thousands of students to build their career successfully and achieve the heights. For education management also, he has been rewarded at national level. So I have a huge list to talk about you, sir, but let's, it's always a pleasure having you here, sir.
Very generous of you.
Thank you. Always a pleasure having you, because I have seen in your workshop, anyone who will just come up with a mind frame of ki dekhte hai kya hota hai will also go after learning.
Thank you, Ji.
Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right. So, good afternoon, everybody. So, it's raining outside here. Bahut hi acha mausam hai, and I'm right now sitting in Skill, a very cozy, creative environment around. And I'm very lucky to get this chance to share a lot of things. I'm having actually a huge list of things that I crave to share with all the students, and let me see how much will it be possible today. Coming to the point, okay, let me share my screen so that we are on the topic and we start talking. So my screen, I am not switching the slideshow. All right, let me keep it like this. Okay, I hope everybody can see it. Okay, guys, we are here to talk about something which is very close to my life. My most of the professional life I have lived close to this topic, that is 3D character animation, one of my passion, one of my topic of research, one of my expertise, as my students say. So nobody's expert actually.
I request if you can make it full screen, please.
Sorry,
full screen mode.
Full screen mode. This my slideshow. I am into another browser, and I was also finding, man, from where to do this is Mozilla. Never used it. I was finding issue in.
Okay. No issues. It's still visible.
But yeah, sitting on the other PC. So I've never used Mozilla.
Okay. No issues. It's still fine. Okay, sir. It's visible.
I've tried pressing some shortcuts also. Okay. Anyways. So, all right. So, guys, talking about this topic, that is the 3D character animation. All right, so let's get started. I'll start with a story of Indian animation education. I've been into this from year 2003, actively into it since 2003, and I'll tell you what I started witnessing when I came into this journey, especially the education, design education, animation education in India, because I have done all my research, grooming, everything in India. So I'm in a fair position to talk about the scenario of Indian animation education. If I talk about 2003, the scenario was like that. There were many computer centers, and still there is, you know, the chain is going on of computer centers. And at the time, there was huge hype of that there were computer centers for different things. It started with IT boom, when so many computer centers came into picture, and they were teaching different languages. And then they also started including many software packages, like some DTP softwares, like PageMaker and all those things, Word and all those, because those were the times when basic computer education was just pushing into the mainstream. They were just getting included into, you know, the society, when everybody wanted to use Word and all those things. And during those times, some computer centers felt like, why not expand our education to some other softwares? So they started expanding from the languages, from MS Word and all those, Windows and this and that. And they started expanding to some design softwares, because they came to know that, okay, within computer, there is also some design softwares, like Photoshop is there, and then PageMaker, and then there is Illustrator, CorelDRAW is there. So they started teaching those. And what would they call that course? They would call that course some design course, graphic design course, because they are teaching those softwares. Slowly, they came to know that, okay, there are some premium softwares, like 3D software is there, 3ds Max is there. So they planned, why not teach 3ds Max? So they included that. Now what that becomes, what will they call that course? They will call that course animation course, 3D course. They would call, ideally, they would love to call it 3D animation course. So those computer centers, or I can say the chain of computer centers, mostly there was franchisee model, and that model is still running. Franchisee model is what? That when one body defines a course, and then he does business deals with different parties around the country or around the states, telling them that, okay, you deliver this under my name, and you are going to get my branding, but you are going to share the finances. So this model is successful when there are set list of features that you have to teach for softwares. If one body, main body in India, says that, okay, you teach Photoshop, Illustrator, CorelDRAW, 3ds Max, Premiere, these softwares, and I'll just list out the course or the features that you need to teach, and you just need to meet these topics, and we are going to certify you that you have delivered our course, and we are going to give that brand to your students as well as to your center. So this is something called franchising model, and it's very sort of successful when the teaching is very objective. And it's very objective, it's very set, it's like, fine, this is the software and these are the tools that you need to teach or learn. I would like to mention here a big personality of animation industry. His name is Ed Hooks. Ed Hooks, E.D. Hooks. He is one of the pioneers for the subject of acting for animation. He's the first person hired by animation industry, animation studios, to teach acting. He was actually a acting teacher belonging to live action theater world in Hollywood. And he was a person who was hired by DreamWorks around in 1995. And that was the first time that the concept of acting for animation came up. So otherwise, it used to be just acting, you know? And there was nothing called acting for animation. So he's the person, this is a huge subject in itself. We may talk it sometime later. But what I want to come down to is this huge personality, when he visited India, that was also around that same time, 2004-5, or I think later on, near 6-7. So when he visited India, he wrote an article after that. He issued some statements regarding the animation education in India, which he still endorsed even after 8-10 years. Like even in 2011-12 also, he still was of the same opinion. What was his opinion? He said, the animation education in India has come through computer centers. They are not animation educators. They are computer centers. It has come into India through computer centers. And those bodies, Indian education bodies, they think that animation is a software-based education. They think, because it has come through computer centers, and they think that it's a type of computer education. It's a type of software education, when actually it is not at all. There is nothing can be far, far more far from the truth. Animation is not that. So that is why the animation studios in India have started taking the role of academy, because they know that they are not getting the rightly educated and trained people. And so they have extended their department to make a training unit, some of the animation studios in India, and they are trying to train the students, which they just pick and shortlist, and they prepare and train them for their own productions. So I'm just quoting this statement to tell you about the scenario of animation education as it is growing in India. Now I'm going to tell you around 2006 or 7, while I was also having experience of animation education through, you know, such franchisee models. There are so many big names. You all know all the big names of franchisee model who are imparting education in the name of animation. They are, as Adhuk says, they are more of computer centers trying to teach some tools and labeling it as a course or program in animation, while it is actually a course of those tools. What I witnessed while I was in the middle of these, you know, experiencing these centers, in 2006, we witnessed nice 3D animation reels, show reels, nice 3D animation reels by students. We just spotted it online, just being shared, looking very interesting, being shared by faculties and students. And when we saw, it was so interesting. There were, you know, very simple rigs. The characters were very simple, like not having any faces or nothing like that. And but still very engaging. I'll just stop sharing for a moment so that we while we are talking, we can, you know, interact, and then I'll again share. So what I was saying is, we spotted those reels. Those were quite interesting. Like they were simple characters and they were doing such amazing moves. And we came to know that these are works by some students. And the first curiosity is from where these are learning, what students are they? And we came to know that this is some Hollywood school, and that and Hollywood school is teaching character animation. And this is the magic being created by those students. we were really shocked and also were you know very confused, because I was also part of that animation education in India when most of the education was being given through softwares, and we were putting a lot of effort on that, and still we were not getting the results. Like our main pain was that we are teaching everything that the franchisee head is telling us. All the franchisee people, all the centers are doing what they are being told. Why still the students are not able to create a shining showreel portfolio or work like this? If animation education is about learning all the tools that is served as a buffet in front of a student when a student goes to a center and asks for a course, and he's given, okay, man, in 1.5 years, you will be taught this. And we were thinking, like, we are teaching all those things to students. Why still the students are nowhere near these reels? What's the problem? Then I got interested into this particular line that actually, you know, was fascinating for me to see those reels. And I went deep into it. What the hell it is? What are these people doing? I came to know that this is an online school put together by 3 Hollywood expert animators. And the name of the school is Animation Mentor. I said, fine. Let us research that. After that, we as a team started researching all their methodologies, all their exercises. Then we studied some competing schools. Among those competing schools were Anim School, that actually came later. It was the Animation Mentor only who was pioneering this type of training. And then there was Anim School, then iAnimate. These schools came up. So we studied that, okay, man, they are training for around 18 months. And in 18 months, they are not teaching any software. They are asking it to be prerequisite to be knowing the basics of a 3D software like Maya. And they are not bothered about any software. So that is none of their business. And they are going to give you education in character animation, which makes it very clear that character animation training is very different from software teaching. It has got nothing to do with software teaching. So they are saying you just learn your basic software and then come to us, and we are going to start teaching you character animation from zero, from bouncing ball, for 18 months. And we are not going to teach you any software. We are not going to answer any question related to the softwares. So that was totally a different methodology, different way of teaching, cannot be seen till date in any of the centers, any of the franchisee model. Till date, nobody is teaching like that. And they were teaching like that, and they were creating magic. Slowly, slowly, by 2010, 11, 12, you won't believe, most of the 3D character animation workforce working in Pixar or similar level studios, more than 80% of the artists were those who got trained through such schools, such training patterns. We as a team decided at that time that, man, why don't we start something like this in India? Why don't we train people like this? Why don't we take them to, why are we not able to create students who are directly qualified or directly hired for Hollywood shows? Because I had witnessed since 2003, I'm saying that even very honestly and sincerely pursuing all the instructions of franchisee heads, of franchise, of following all the, you know, syllabus, all the instructions, all the methodologies, we were ending up with students who had knowledge of a lot of softwares and who had some works, though those were mediocre or less than that, but they had works of various kinds, but none know what was of the quality that could directly qualify them for Hollywood shows. So that was a challenge we always, that gave us pain, that why are we not sitting in Chandigarh, train a person who can directly get hired for a Hollywood show. So this gave us a signal that, okay, man, let's try something like this. And so we went to thorough research, very thorough research. We did all the exercises with our own hands, even being mentors. We did all those exercises of Animation Mentor, 11 Second Club. 11 Second Club is just the competition portal of Animation Mentor, like Anim School and all those. We went into their whole procedure, all the exercises. Then on top of that, another research that intrigued us a lot was the classes by Walt Stanchfield. Walt Stanchfield happens to be a teacher in Disney Studios. He taught there for 20 years. Walt Disney Studio, where there is a collection of expert animators, professional animators. This guy, Walt Stanchfield, is the person who delivered classes to those professionals for 20 years. So that person actually, during this course of 20 years, he used to deliver the classes. He used to publish every lecture in the form of a note and used to paste it in the studio. And those notes then later on were collected and formed two big volumes. So those two big volumes, when released in the animation world, they created waves. So when we also came to know that, okay, man, there is a collection of those teachings that Walt Stanchfield was giving in Disney Studios. So we took that and we thoroughly studied that. Thoroughly means one lecture in one day. So if there were in one collection, there was 350 lectures. So I personally took 350 days to study that, one lecture per day. I said, if the person has, you know, created this volume in 20 years, I cannot read it in 5 days. No, I will not. I'll do justice. I will just grasp each and every lecture. So for 350 in one volume and 250 in another, you just imagine 1 or 2 years I just took to read each and every lecture in that, you know, volume of Walt Stanchfield. He was giving the very trade secret teaching in that, which actually creates that Disney magic. That's a real exercise which again, and this is another topic that I was so much astonished that, man, this person, we all are talking about animation. We in India all are talking about animation, and we are talking about animation education. What better source for this? What better source can be than the, you know, temple of animation, that is Walt Disney Studios? And what better source than the Walt Stanchfield, the teacher in that temple? He's the guy, he's actually the first teacher of animation. So if we don't look at him, the people who created the magic and the teacher who taught how to create that magic, if we are not looking at that person, what are we doing? Are we making fool of ourselves and also the students? So what that Walt Stanchfield was teaching in 20 years, no center in India, neither any college, neither any university, I saw talking about that. Everybody's talking about what? Everybody's talking about Maya, Max. Everybody's talking about which software in this syllabus, which software are you giving me in this course? That's it. Walt Stanchfield was never talking about any software. He was talking about something else. That is what we want to share. We are sharing at Skill in Chandigarh now, after so many years of research. That is the trick of the trade that gives you a head-on start into advanced character animation, into a character animation that is full of life, that is full of mind, that is full of emotion. So that is what he was teaching. It's another kind of gesture study. So these two sources I'm mentioning, one is Animation Mentor and all those training programs and Hollywood animation programs. And then the another sources is Walt Stanchfield, and another source was Seamus Cullen. He's also a genius of that time. He was also, you know, artist in Walt Disney Studio. He went into research of, you know, creative flights while doing animation, how to get into creative flights while doing animation. So this is another guy, Seamus Cullen. And Seamus Cullen is the person who mentions the father of all art education, that is Kimon Nicolaides. This is another name. Kimon Nicolaides is the father of all art education, be it animation, be it drawing, painting, be it caricaturing, be it character design. That person names is Kimon Nicolaides, and his device exercises, the exercise that he researched for many years and he gave to this world, is compiled in the Natural Way to Draw book, and that was published in 1928. Again, another source which is being used by the top educators of the world, like Sheridan College or even CalArts. All the top artists are using this source. Again, this source is not seen anywhere in India. No center, no college is talking about Kimon Nicolaides. Nobody is talking about Walt Stanchfield. Nobody is talking about those 3D exercises that Hollywood teachers are delivering to so many students who are getting straight into Pixar. So now that brings us to a lot of questions and puts us to find answers. So then we thought that, okay, man, if you want to bring this kind of education in India, what we need to do. First, we came to know that, okay, if we guide the students of India that, theek hai yaar, chalo, just join Animation Mentor and all those schools. Then we came to know that they are very, very expensive. They're very expensive. A normal parent of India will not be able to afford that. If we have to do, and most of the Indians would also not be able to follow those instructions online, because they are teaching online, and of course they are international trainers, and their cost is so much that even if I tried, and you know, just for experiment, I asked some students that why don't you join, they found it too expensive. And so our main motivation now was to bring together all this top and animation education that sums up the Hollywood character animation, 3D animation exercises, and includes the Walt Stanchfield exercises of 20 years, and also includes Kimon Nicolaides exercises. So we joined all these and we did a small experiment in 2011. The experiment was to, can we do the same magic in India and even in a shorter time? So if Animation Mentor is taking around 18 months, how about if we plan around 6 to 9 months? What can we achieve? So we took out a group as an experiment. It was a pass out from one of the degree programs of the running programs at that time of animation. And they were not, of course, getting absorbed in any animation studio. We took those students, around 5-6 of different caliber, below also, top also. Among those were those who were academically categorized not very good, who one of them was even not able to clear plus 2, 12th, one subject he couldn't clear. And it was such a group. So they were good also, all type of people were there. So we wanted to experiment these exercises on them. We experimented with them from 6 to 9 months. And this was the first encouraging moment for me, for us, for the team of Skill on the path of this character animation education program. Because I remember that day, that when earlier experience of mine was that we were craving that if some of my student gets job offer from top studios doing Hollywood work, Hollywood shows, if that was a craving that maybe just one student can get through that. And we used to, you know, help them write the covering letter, the resumes, so that they can offer in it, they can apply in a nice manner. And I remember that day that when these students who went through these exercises, and I was with them, and what I was writing was how to deny the offers politely, because those students got offers from 4 top studios of India who were doing Hollywood shows, and they all offered them. What they did were they just sent their showreels to them, and might be for the studios it was a happy surprise because they were not getting such applications from around the India. So when they saw such a reel, they immediately offered. 4 studios directly offered them the job, and now they were with me, and I literally help them write the letter, how to refuse the offer and still keep the relationship with other studios. So that was one, you know, big magical moment and big success, I would say, that experiment. After that, we rolled out those courses. And this was one story I'm mentioning. Within Skill, we have story for different streams. For design also is there, for UI UX is also there. Different streams are there, but I'm now right now, because I have to focus on character animation. This is how our journey went, because at Skill, it's like an evolving lab where the target is just to bring the top available international education and then innovate onto that. So we, for character animation education, we just brought together all the top experiments successful till date. Starts from Disney, then the Hollywood educators of character animation, like Animation Mentor and all. And then we devised a combined exercise, and within 6 to 9 months, they were able to create that lifelike animations, and still are, curriculum or that program is still going every year. And now we have just made it a compulsory part of the program, that we ask the students to participate in 11 Second Club. 11 Second Club, as I mentioned, it's a competition started by Animation Mentor, which is an international competition held monthly, where they give a situation or a dialogue, and all the professionals or even students participate in that. And then they, on the basis of rating, they decide who is the top, what is the ranking, like who is first, second, third, fourth. And coming into top 20 is also a very, very big achievement. And I must share here that our students, first time when we made them participate in that, they came in top 20 ranks are mostly packed by professionals with experience, more than 5 years experience. It was first time that I ever saw some fresher with zero experience coming into top 10. If you go to 11 Second Club, there is a history of all the competitions and applicants. You will see that you won't ever find a fresher coming in top 10. So this is one guy who, Lalit was one guy who just came into top 10, and later on also every year we find them into top 10 or 20, which actually endorses this kind of training. All right, I'm not stopped speaking. Actually, I have made the presentation on some other lines, but I, being very passionate about it, I went into another angle, because that was actual story of how I witnessed the animation education from my point of view in India, and how we are already here at this level that we are in a position to deliver. Not even on position, we have already been delivering the international animation education in India. And one point that I mentioned, that one motivation, big motivation, was that if that education for Indian was so expensive, like it's still expensive to go for Animation Mentor or all these training programs. We have tried to keep it so low so that every Indian, it becomes reachable for every Indian. So the quality or the type of education that we are trying to bring here is actually so expensive internationally that it becomes very difficult for parents to get ready for it. So this is one major thing that we have tried, that we have tried to keep it as low so that we solve the purpose. We reach we solve the problem statement. Problem statement is to bring that international education to India and make it approachable by all Indian parents and students. Okay, so if we have some time, I'm going to quickly go through this. Many things I must have already mentioned. Actually, this is a presentation I have created for dealing with the question, what is 3D character animation? We all are having the same problem, which we find with all the students passing out from most of the centers, colleges, universities. They do full course, they have done all the subjects they were offered, and still the doors of top animation studios are closed for them. And then students come to us and they ask, okay, why are we not getting job, how to get that job. So I created this presentation directly hitting that point, what we should do and what we should not do. Actually, this presentation as a whole takes a lot of time. I'm going to just give an overview. Otherwise, it's 1.5 hours long presentation, but I'm going to quickly go through it to tell you something. Character animation, there is so much passion in India, but there's so less clarity. Students are not clear, faculties are not clear, centers are not clear, colleges are not clear. For colleges and universities, actually this education is really new. Really new, because it's entering the mainstream just 6-7 years back. It has started entering the mainstream. So before 2012-11, it was all centers, those franchisee model computer centers turned into so-called animation courses. And then there are colleges entering, and even if the college and university is sincere, because the stream is too new, so they are still trying to figure out that how to teach, what to teach, because the courses they have been, the degree programs they have been delivering for years, the nature of this particular stream is very different from that. So they are still figuring out that how to go about it. So there's so much of passion, so less clarity. The main question that everybody is facing is what to learn and what not to learn. Should I learn drawing? Should I learn 2D animation, classical animation? Which all softwares, all multimedia softwares, which 3D softwares, acting or theater? Actually, these questions you will appreciate more if you were somebody who was already into 3D character animation. And then you would easily empathize with this, that, okay, yes, I'm feeling these questions. But if you are right now in a position, like you are right now thinking about where to join and what to do, you may not be very familiar with these questions. Otherwise, these are the questions that anybody who starts learning animation, they face. क्या मुझे ड्रॉइंग सीखनी है, मुझे क्या 2D क्लासिकल एनिमेशन सीखना पड़ेगा, नहीं सीखना पड़ेगा, विच ऑल सॉफ्टवेयर्स आई विल हैव टू डू, एंड शुड आई लर्न एक्टिंग थिएटर और नॉट, राइट, टू बिकम कैरेक्टर एनिमेटर, टू बिकम अ परफॉर्मर विद द कैरेक्टर. ओके, सो आई विल क्विकली गो थ्रू ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस, विच एज आई एम सेइंग, इफ यू आर पास आउट और यू आर गोइंग थ्रू सम दिस काइंड ऑफ कोर्स, then you can relate to it very, very closely. Otherwise, you will have an idea that yes, this can be a question, and this is going to solve many questions that you will be facing in future. So first question is, should I learn drawing? Should I learn drawing? This is the first question. I say if you don't learn drawing, because everybody would be having this doubt, and many are actually very afraid of also animation, because they have an idea or they have an impression that without good drawing, they cannot be good 3D character animators. So this is something that I want to break here, that if you don't know drawing, it's actually possible to become top class 3D character animators. This is a big myth being broken here. And this is, again, huge credit to those Hollywood trainers who started all that campaign that I was talking about in 2006. And then because their campaign was totally not dependent upon drawing. And as I was mentioning earlier also, most of the Pixar animators, 80% of 3D character animation force are those who don't actually are very good in 2D animation or drawing. So if you don't learn drawing, if you are not good in drawing, it's still possible to be very good with 3D character animation. You can create top quality Hollywood character animations without learning drawing. Fine. We have got huge experiments with us also. We have at the end, I actually tried to prepare slides of all my students also, our students also. But I couldn't put their photographs and all, but I do have names and shows on which they worked on. And we, if anybody approaches us, we share all the details of our ex-students. Details include the contact numbers. They can come and they, if you contact me, I can give you direct contact numbers of the pass out students who are working in top studios like Technicolor, working on top Hollywood shows right now in Xantrix, in similar other studios. Technicolor is one name which doesn't have much competitors. So many students are working in Technicolor. So we actually share their phone numbers. You can talk to them and you can ask them about their experience in skill. All right. If somebody says, man, you are saying that you don't need to learn drawing, but I love drawing. I want to learn drawing. Fine. If yes, should I learn drawing? If yes, agar aap sikhna chahte ho, to acha hai. So my question was, agar nahi, kya possible hai? Yes, it's possible. Aur agar haan sikhte ho, to acha hai. Better it is. Kuch aspects hai, jo tumhe plus de denge, jo yahan pe mentioned hai, drawing trains you in eye for detail. Drawing will help you study gestures. Drawing will help you in planning a shot. And drawing indicates your comfort of working in right brain mode. These are all detailed subjects. We may talk about these in some other session if we meet. Okay, if somebody says, okay, I want to learn drawing, then what should I learn in drawing if I'm interested in becoming an animator? If you want to become an animator, you don't have to go into contour form anatomy. No. I'm talking about character animation. I'm not talking about film designing. I'm not talking about pre-production. I'm not talking about storyboarding. I'm talking about character animation. So if you want to focus on character animation, do you need these? No, you don't need these studies. This is one thing that you need. You need gesture, expression, mind, emotion. This is the study that you actually need. And this is the one thing that I was mentioning was taught by Timon Nicolaides, was taught by Walt Stanchfield in Disney Studios for 20 years, and also by Seamus Gulley, advocated by Seamus Gulley. So you need to learn gestures, expressions, mind, emotion. There are specific exercises that Timon Nicolaides devised for this. If you do that exercise, those exercises, you will directly grasp these aspects of a drawing: gesture, expression, mind, and emotion. All right, coming to the next. Can I zoom in a bit? No, I'm not able to. Anyways, yeah. Okay. Is it helpful? Maybe. Okay. So, another thing of drawing. Should we learn shading, light and shading? Should I learn?
Okay, so here we are facing some technical issue and sir is dropped because of electricity. You know, guys, we are in Mohali, Chandigarh, and there's a beautiful, beautiful rain going on. But the pros and cons, the electricity issue is there. So sir is quickly joining back, so don't worry. So how many of you have actually learned from today's session, and what exactly have you learned? You can send your message in the chat window. So I'm checking the chat window and I see when you talk about 3D animation, what are your points that you want to cover? Is it just the character animation that you're looking for, or is it about the animation, animating entire scene? The pataka, it's nice to see even professionals on the platform. It's sad to see they're not getting enough recognition though. Yes, that's true. But you know what, industry, when you enter one industry, even if maybe layman doesn't know you, but the industry actually respects the professionals, and yes, the thorough professional people. If you'll give me your name, yes, Banti Das, I would love to animate the entire scene. Now, I'd really like to know what kind of scenes. Now, when we are talking about 3D animation, you must have watched various movies in animation, right? So which, okay, let's give the name of your favorite movie. Favorite animation movie that you'd like, you know, to be a character, or you wish ki your name would have been there in the credits. Okay, Life of a Pi. And you know, I'd like to mention one thing. When you're watching a movie, at the end, there are credits given, right? Always watch or read the names in the credits. These are the actual people who have worked so hard to get their names in the credit, to get their you know, work being credited in you know, big movies and big names. Yes, Life of Pi and The Lion King. Who all have watched The Lion King part 1, part 2, any part? Although I watched this one, the Mowgli, right? The Jungle Book. The Jungle Book. Now, when we talk about The Jungle Book, I think 90% of people will relate to it. how you have spent your Sunday watching the Jungle Book, or how you have been behaving like Mowgli when you see animals, and when there is a rainy season, and you know, you want to play in the park, you want to climb up. Bhanti Das wants to say, my latest animation movie is Luca. It's a story. Its story is great, and obviously the whole animation modeling, etc. Okay, wonderful. There was another movie, Mama, where this kiddo enters the world of dead people, and then he returns. Does anybody remember? With Mama Poco, something was the name of the grandmother. Mama Coco? Yes, Coco. Coco was the movie, right? Raminder sir is joining back. He'll take this workshop ahead. And soon he'll start up with the other other screen of the presentation, the slide, because he's prepared a very, very wonderful presentation. So tell me something about, yes, that was Coco movie, right? Now, when I talk about animation movies, what's your favorite series, the cartoon series that you like watching? So I think we have all boys today, because nobody is talking about Frozen or the Disney movie. And even whether the movie is animated or no, rather all the movies are animated nowadays. You all have seen the work of animation of the visual effects done in Bahubali, plus the work of various other movies like Twilight Saga, and if you you'd like to name more movies like Toy Story, all the Spider-Man, when we talk about the Spider-Man, such a wonderful movie, and it's full of animation. Incredibles is another good movie. Zootopia, does anybody remember Zootopia, the movie of jungle, like animals were there. How about if I talk about the movie Finding Nemo? Who all remember Finding Nemo? That cute little Nemo. And how about, can you give me the name of movies? Some more movies that we can talk about. Okay. Now I'm getting messages. Moana, yes. How the spirit of this very, very small girl, Moana, to, reach the other world. Yes. I just felt that sir is back, but it's taking a little while. Okay, guys, you can tell me, kis kis ki yahan barish ho rahi hai? Let me take this opportunity to chat and talk with you all. Kahan kahan barish ho rahi hai is time? So I'd like to know. who all are facing this, you know, getting this beautiful weather, and who all are thinking of having, you know, a nice art book, sit in your balcony or in the garden where you can see the rain and you can draw a little. Anybody good in drawing? Wants to share anything? Okay, I have Nizam, and Nizam is saying he loves rain, but he can't draw. Okay, no issues. Can anybody draw? Last time we had a workshop on how to draw. So, Bhanti Das, where are you from? You know what? I'm planning to have a live discussion. Now, soon we'll plan a session where all of us can be live and on a meeting where we can talk also. And I, instead of getting the messages, I can get your answers. You know, allow me a minute to take this call, please. I'm sorry, I was talking to sir, and he's quickly joining us back. So this rainy monsoon season is here. Who all like the monsoon season? You can send me a message. Okay, I got one more message that they like rainy season. I got a message from Nidhi, and the best part about rainy season is, ma'am, that cup of tea and pakore. Okay, nice. So who all share the same feeling? I'll say the feelings are mutual. I even feel like having a cup of tea now. Okay, and diet conscious. Okay, so people are diet conscious. They don't like pakoras. Okay, cool. You can share your personal points about monsoon. What's your favorite thing about monsoon? Nidhi, I really liked your answer, the chai and pakora, because I'm myself a tea lover. Exactly. What Nidhi is saying, ma'am, people say, garmi mein chai kaun peeta hai? And then I don't feel like talking to them. Same here. Feelings are mutual here. Okay. Another part, another good part of monsoon is you can stay at home, relax, yeah. Relax in fresh air. Because otherwise you have to stay in the AC in the summers, right? So this is the best part to enjoy the breeze, enjoy the weather, enjoy the atmosphere, the environment outside. And everything becomes so clean and fresh. Now enough of chit-chatting. Let me start talking about MCAT. Guys, as you all are aware, MCAT is for taking admissions in the premium institutions with the benefit of scholarship. Yeah. So all your hurdles that you can't take admission in so and so institution because of the fee structure or some kind of finances constraints, they are all answered with MCAT. You can earn up to 100% scholarship. And here, the best part is whatever your scholarship is, it's equivalent to the score that you earn. And MESC, Media and Entertainment Skills Council, is even supporting you all to prepare for MCAT via these workshops. And these workshops are conducted by premium institutions of media and entertainment in the country. All the partnered institutions are associated. They are planning to make you prepared. They all want that our Indians, our students, the aspirants of media and entertainment, get the benefit of MCAT and earn the maximum possible scholarship. And yes, if you can score 100%, you can earn 100% scholarship as well. So it's all depends. It depends on you. And in fact, one more thing, when we have someone who is, offering you admission in one institution, or you have a choice, like, when given a choice that I want to go in XYZ institution, and that institution is available to me at a very, very minimal cost, or the best part is when they're offering me scholarship. So I'm quickly checking with sir if he can be available soon. Okay, so I think I think we should give it a try. If it works, otherwise we'll close the session today and we'll inform you about upcoming sessions. Tomorrow we have a workshop with Mr. Vineet Raj Kapoor with Skill, and tomorrow we are going to learn from him about of course his premium institution Skill, and along with his institution he is going to share the information on UX research. Now this is one topic which has never happened on our platform, so that's a very very exciting topic, and we'll be happy to meet Mr. Vineet Raj Kapoor tomorrow. Yes, sir. Parminder sir is back.
Yeah, not totally back. Basically, there has been some connection issues. So I sit on through my mobile. I said I cannot stay away from my audience. So let me see how much I can interact and conclude my talk. I'm very sorry, guys. There has been some technical glitch. So I lost my connection from my system and getting repaired. Our experts are there. Anyway, so let me just continue without slide. Let me see how much I can carry forward. We were actually onto the phase when I was talking about that what all is needed to become a 3D character animator. We were just concluding towards that end. So I had 4 points that I mentioned on my slides. So first point was, do we need drawing? Second was, do we need 2D classical animation? Third is, do we need which softwares do we need? And fourth was, do we need acting? So guys, first point, drawing. I told you, we actually can do very well without drawing. Drawing can be an add-on. It is very helpful in your planning in the shot, but still there are alternative methods to do the same thing. So if you are not good in drawing, you can very much attempt and do top quality character animation, Hollywood quality, and there are huge lot of man force we can witness in Pixar and all other Hollywood shows which are not actually good in drawing. Point number two, do we need to learn 2D classical animation? This thought actually started from CallArts Animation College. CallArts is actually the pioneer which came out of from Walt Disney Studios. CallArts is one of the earliest animation educators. So at that time, the education was totally classical animation based. So one could only think of teaching animation through light tables and papers on the peg bar. That was the only way to teach all the animation concepts. So this school of thought comes from there, that if one has to learn animation, the only right way to teach is through classical methods. So no doubt learning classical animation is something that gives you a huge or great eye for detail. You get a habit of working in too much of detail, and there are so many aspects that you directly touch while learning classical animation. But to become 3D character animator, you don't have to learn classical animation. Classical animation in itself is a big rigorous journey. It's in itself a tapasya in itself. To learn classical animation, you have to focus for at least 2 years into that field to really become good classical animator. But to become a very good 3D character animator, this is not a necessity. You can become very good 3D character animator without learning 2D classical animation. This again is backed by the fact that most of the 3D character animators are not classical animators, similar to drawing. Because the way I was saying that there are most of the people, more than 80%, don't know good drawing. So that actually means that they cannot animate classical. Animation drawing. Do I need to
when you learn software, can you survive without software? Yes. In fact, even if you don't learn any software and you know animation through classical behavior, you can still do very good animation. Just hold for a moment. All right. So this is the third thing about. All right. I hope I'm audible. Yeah. We are great fighters. We'll keep on coming back. So the third thing is about softwares. So extreme, you don't know any software, but you know very good animation. This is the exceptional cases. Then very good classical animators are hired by studios and they teach them their tools. Let us leave this exceptional thing because we are doing classical animation also. So which software you should learn to pitch yourself for top positions in animation departments of Hollywood shows? Which software you should know? Ideally, the very top studios have their own tools. They have their own software. So if you have practiced character animation in 3D environment using any 3D software, it's good for them. Because what they want to know is, or what they want to say is, if you know the craft, the art of character animation in any 3D environment, in any 3D software. So because most popular within the industry and within the education system also is Maya, so it's good enough if you learn Maya, but you don't need to learn full Maya if you want to pitch just for character animation department. So learning just the interface and animation tool, relevant animation tools, is good enough. So why I'm telling all those things, this is what I'm telling right now, is the shortest cut to top positions in character animation. I'm not saying you don't learn. If you learn, better it is. In my slide, that is what I'm mentioning in each slide. If you learn 2D classical animation, better it is. If you learn drawing, better it is. If you learn full Maya, better it is. But this is the bare minimum. If you just learn the tools which are needed to handle the characters in Maya, that's good for enough. Good and enough. And moreover, if you learn all the tools which are needed to tweak the animation, that is your setting of keys and your graph editor and all, that is good enough for character animation. Otherwise, if you have to learn, what we would recommend is one 3D platform in which you can handle the character animation. Additionally, you should learn supporting softwares like Photoshop and After Effects, which also helps in compositing the renders. So these are those softwares which are around the character animation department, which you might need for other things, creating assets, texturing, and Premiere and audio video editing you might need, because once you take the output out from the 3D software, you will may need to add sound and edit the video. So these are some of the basic tools which you may need, which is not actually the main thing. Main education lies much above the tools. And fourth topic I mentioned was, do you need to learn acting? Now this is again big topic, which we, all these four points actually are big topic, which I usually take 2 hours to discuss, but because the main crux I've already mentioned to you before those slides, now I'm just making go through these things. So the fourth point is, do you need to learn acting? Again, I would like to mention Ed Hooks, which I mentioned earlier also. He's the one guy who went into this topic of acting for animation. And he figured out something very strange. Like everybody otherwise would feel that acting is also sorry, animation is also performance. If all the characters are actually acting, so I should learn to act, because that's important. I should learn to act if I want to learn to make my characters act. If I want my characters to act, I should be knowing acting. So I should be able to act in front of camera. So this used to be some kind of notion when Edwards started into this field in 1995. And his very first day experience, first week experience taught him a lot when he tried to train the character animators on the lines of live actors. And he started teaching them, he asked them to come to the stage and do and this and that. After a week, he felt that he was a failure. He was not able to teach them anything. And the animators were also not having very good experience. Then Edwin thought, there might be something wrong with me, man. I'm not coaching the topic correctly. He realized that they are animators. They are not supposed to be acting in front of camera. They should not be good enough to act in front of camera. What they should be good at is to create a convincing animation acting performance in their characters. So acting performance should be in their characters, not in them. They may not be able to perform perfectly in front of camera. So he realized what is important for animator is not to learn how to act, but to learn what all is needed in acting. All the elements of acting. All the principles of acting. So he then created the book, Principles of Acting, Acting for Animation. So he shared all the principles. So for an animator, it's not compulsory for you to learn to act. So somebody, if you are having an inhibition, no, I cannot act or I cannot go in front of camera, fine, no issue. You don't need to learn that. You just need to learn that what is needed in an acting, what are essentials in an acting performance, so that you can take care of those things while you are making your character act, right? So that is what is needed. So I'm saying, I have mentioned four things: drawing, 2D and animation, the softwares, and the acting. And in all the four things, I'm almost saying no, you don't need to learn this and that. So what exactly you need to learn? What exactly you need to learn? The answer lies in one saying, that art is a reflection of life. Art is a reflection of life. So how to learn art? Answer is in this simple line only. There are three things that are important. Art is the reflection of life. So to learn art, you have to just absorb three things. First is life. If art is life, so unless you expose yourself to life, you cannot learn art. So you will have to, first thing is you have to expose yourself to life if you want to learn an art. So just learning software, computer, tools, you will not end up anywhere. If you want to make your art richer, you will have to absorb life. Once you absorb life, that life experience comes out in the form of performance or artistic artworks. Second thing is, expose yourself to art. Reflection. Art is a reflection of life. Reflection. Expose yourself to reflection. What are reflections? Other artworks. So first of all, you expose yourself to life. And for animation, there are so many exercises to expose yourself to life. Gesture exercises, one main exercise in which you experience life, you experience gesticulation, you experience people, you experience mannerism. That is exposure to life. Then you expose yourself to reflection. You see other pieces of work. You see and absorb other animation styles, other already done top class works. So there are other exercises to absorb these also. And third is reflect. Unless you reflect yourself, unless you create yourself, you will not be able to absorb either life or reflection. When you reflect yourself, you create work yourself. Only then an appetite is created in yourself to absorb gestures, to absorb the nuances of others' animation. So actually, I'm combating it. It's a heavy topic. It takes a lot of time to understand what I'm trying to say right now. But looking at the time constraint, I'm just making it short. If we meet sometime else, I'm going to expand on that. So in a nutshell, what you need to do is, to become top quality 3D character animator, you just need to do exercises under an expert mentor. The exercises that will let you expose yourself to life through gesture exercise of Walt Sanchez, that will let you expose you to the other reflections, other pieces of art. And third, which makes you reflect in a step-by-step way, which makes you create animations in a step-by-step way, starting from bouncing ball, very simple, and ending at a top quality, high-end acting performance. That is what you need to do. At the end, last slide, I want to show the list of all the films and all the Hollywood shows that they have worked now. But I welcome all of you to contact me, contact Skill Chandigarh. If you search Skill Chandigarh on the Google or YouTube, you will just find us there. You just contact us. We can directly give you the link or the details of all our pass outs. You can talk to them, understand what they have gone through and how they touched the success that they are right now on. Right? So we are going to wait for you. We will we are very much open to talk in detail about your career aspirations. If you have any questions, rather more than courses, we have got a lot of experience in animation education in India. So if you have want to have general guidance with us, that what we can suggest you, that what to go through, what to do or what to don't do, you're most welcome. You would, our first preference to put the people, put the students like you to the right path so that they don't waste their money, they don't waste their precious time. So they cut short and directly hit the success. So that is our prime focus. So please contact us. Feel free to discuss about your career questions. We are going to guide you very in a very neutral way, very fairly. We'll just tell you that you do this or you don't do this. We can even guide you that, okay, don't come into this career. If we perceive that way in you, that you are good for that or not, we can even go so much fair that, no, you should not pursue this. So please feel free to talk to us. And we feel really great when we get a chance to guide any spirit like you. I think that is good enough for today. We'll meet someday again.
So you always been in pieces.
I made the show.
So I think there was some technical that overlapping went. I must say that you have always been very, very different from, a very, very unique personality you have. And I thoroughly enjoy your work.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And how, guys, now today we have seen how warrior sir is after so many technical issues, after so many, electricity issues, he never gave up. He never give up on their students, and he's always there. He is always at the back to push them to reach the heights. So it's really amazing, sir. Thank you so much for this wonderful work.
Thank you, ma'am.
And yes, tomorrow we are coming up with Mr. Vineet Raj Kapoor ji, and the workshop is on UX research, and this is for the first time. This topic has come up, UX research, and yes, definitely we are going to learn a lot from him. And he's again from Skill. So tomorrow, 3 p.m., we'll have Mr. Vineet Raj Kapoorji, game designer, mentor at Skill, and CEO VirtualSoft. Along after him, we'll have another workshop with Okay, let me quickly open now. My system is giving me some trouble. So 22nd again, there's another workshop that's planned. So every day there is a workshop planned, and I'm quickly sharing another screen with the update. Is my screen visible? Okay, so we have Mr. Krishna Dev. He's a filmmaker and he's going to give a workshop on filmmaking and prepare for MCAT with Agios Nova. 22nd, 4:30 p.m. Now, 23rd, we have another workshop in the morning. Now, this workshop is about, just a minute. Let me quickly. This on 23rd, we'll have a workshop on learning about the benefits and the details of digital sculpting. Now, sculpting, we all know, but doing it digitally it's just a different thing. And that's going to happen with Reliance. Mr. Niranjan Kumarji, he's 3D generalist. He's going to guide you on Friday, 11:30 a.m. on digital sculpting. The entire next week is also booked to prepare you for MCAT. And as I've mentioned, on 23rd, we'll have Mr. Niranjan Kumarji. So I am very excited about this week and upcoming week also. You all are learning and we all are growing towards a better nation, towards a skilled nation. And that's the vision of our Honorable Prime Minister, to make India a skill capital of the world. So let's take your leave. We'll see you tomorrow for the workshop at 3 o'clock. Bye-bye.